This story will cover from then to now and next, all about change, how to turn losers into winners. When a shark turns up in tourist-crowded Majorca, it's front-page news, plus more inside, using the familiar inflammatory words. Panic. Terror. Killer. Huge. Lurking. Man-eater. Razor tooth. Giant beast, etc., etc. On YouTube, predictable music reinforcing the famous or infamous Jaws movie. Do sharks deserve that reputation? What happened in Majorca in June 2017 may affect how you see these creatures of the ocean. Point of view of a blue shark. To this animal, uncharted waters, because they rarely come in so close to the shore, where they would be terrified of people, not the other way round. And then to the beach, certainly out of its depth.
British holidaymakers panic as shark washes ashore on Majorca beach. The 8-foot shark is said to have terrified holidaymakers at three beaches along the coast of the resort before it was caught. But is spotted three times in 3 days.
There are 35 species of sharks encountered in British and Irish waters. Mostly unseen, along with many other marine creatures, it is perhaps the fear of the unknown that works against sharks. The extraordinary looking sunfish swims in a surprising way. Whilst below it, a small cat shark waits for passing prey. Like the rainforest, there are layers of life from the seafloor to the middle zone and on up. Home of the gibbon. And on up to the canopy of the jungle and the surface of the sea. Sharks range far and wide, designed for long-range cruising, but are also able to turn on quick attacks. So could it be that the Majorca blue shark got lost? The media may have implied something using the word man-eater. Most sharks don't go around eating humans. So why are people lost at sea always in shark-infested waters? And will their reputation ever change? Perhaps with the next generation, maybe. Their cousins, the rays, don't have that problem. And hopefully public aquariums will help with an understanding of all life in the sea. But for sharks, it may be a race against time, as we'll see as the drama in Majorca unfolded. For a good, safe, close-up view, you can do no better than admire the amazing design of these ancient creatures, with formidable teeth at one end, powered at the other by a sleek body and tail, and a lot more to it than a killing machine that filmmakers usually depict. What will they be saying this time? Hopefully changing their tune. One of the most elegant is the blue shark, which swims the waters of the whole world, including one fateful day, coming to a beach in the Mediterranean island of Majorca. So returning to our comparison with the rainforest, we are now at the canopy, like the surface of the sea, with lots of light and food. And the world's second biggest fish, harmless, that is, unless you're a plankton or a small fish, the basking shark. We are not harmless to sharks, and cutting the fins off the living creature and throwing them back still alive to die unseen. Up there too, also sieving for plankton, is a massive manta ray. Rays are related to the sharks, all have cartilage instead of bone. The others, the so-called bony fishes, include the remoras, which sucker onto their host. Not parasites, but incredibly adapted opportunists, getting a free ride and feeding on chance. This time it's a big target, the whale shark, the world's biggest fish, up to 35 tons, also feeding on tiny plankton. Sadly for them, some people feed on the shark's fins, in soup. And down there off Majorca is where a blue shark arrived one fateful day. Threatened, not this time for its fins, but something even more sinister. A drama's on its way to where the famous Jaws music is totally inappropriate. All is peaceful now at Can Pastilla Beach, near Palma, Majorca. The sun is low. The once rare Orduin's gulls are searching the 5-kilometer-long beach for yesterday's litter, some of which might be edible, or dangerous even. Sunbeds are empty, not even claimed. Biking, jogging, avoiding rubbish. A sign of the times, now more and more part of life in the ocean. The sharks see that, whales and dolphins too, and it kills them all around the world. Plastic bags look like jellyfish. Whether it's a tropical coral reef or a tourist beach in Spain's Majorca, could it be plastic that's killing blue sharks? Out there. We'll soon find out when this beach at Can Pastilla heats up and the tourists emerge from their homes and hotels for a cooling swim. Out there. At this point, you expect to hear that sound of the Jaws music. Threatening, dangerous, timeless. An image the author of that bestseller, Peter Benchley regretted for the rest of his life, during which he tried to help sharks. But can it be done? Because it's the sound of animal pain, not human pain. The hot and carefree day continues. Toy trains rumble by, past sprouting up sun umbrellas. The police are relaxed, though they would soon be called into action as the public panic. Not yet, though. No lives to guard. Green, no danger. And then time to go home after an uneventful day. But red for danger, perhaps. Or for going shopping for an inflatable shark. To deal with those, all you need is a pin or to pull out the stopper, not a bigger boat. The myth goes on. And they're going to see the real thing, not in the sea though. They've seen Jaws and its sequels, even read the book. Now there's one on the roof, on the way to where we'll get the truth about Majorca's shark.
Holidaymakers panic as shark washes ashore on Majorca beach. The 8-foot shark is said to have terrified holidaymakers at three beaches along the coast of the resort before it was caught. But it spotted 3 times in 3 days.
We love oceans, so says Palmer Aquarium. Whether it's rays or sharks here, they care about them and their future. Deborah Morrison is Director of Conservation.
So the shark actually came in to the, I would say, the southwest coast, really. And this is the Bay of Palma, and this is where the shark was first seen. So this is the area. First of all, the shark was seen on the Saturday around about 1 o'clock, went into this bay here called Illetas. After that, the shark spent the Saturday afternoon, went into 2 other bays. One was Calanova, and the other was Cascatala. And then the Sunday, it went all the way around here and it went onto Campestilla Beach here, which was where we actually saw the shark and evaluated the shark. We were wondering why this animal kept on coming in, because this animal would be in very shallow waters, its pec flippers actually touching the sand. 5 minutes later or 10 minutes later, it would be 200 meters from the coastline. So we were trying to find this animal for a day and a half. We wondered what the problem was with the shark. Obviously, it's not normal here. It's very, very seldom a shark will actually come into the beach. We was supposedly thought that this animal was in bad condition until the Sunday afternoon when we actually found the animal, and effectively this animal was in terrible condition, and our vets decided that the animal was in a point of no return, so therefore we sedated the animal and put the animal down. What we found once we put the animal down was a 7-centimeter fishing hook actually in the esophagus, which is the pipe that runs parallel to the windpipe and it goes to the stomach. Therefore, impossibly, this animal had not eaten for weeks and weeks. Therefore, if the animal can't eat, it can't drink, because they actually absorb the content of water that's in the fish. This fishing hook was in the mouth of the animal, esophagus of the animal, and all this fishing line was actually coming out of its mouth. So we can see that that was the major problem. We also found that the animal had about a 4-centimeter lesion on top of the right eye, which it looks like, we can't actually assure that, but looks like a stab wound just above the right eye. And also the animal had lots of ulcers in the mouth.
Can you show us the pictures?
Yeah, sure. The actual state of the animal was bad. So this is the animal, all sandy. We gave the animal a wash down. This is the fishing line coming out of the mouth. Very, very thin, terribly thin. I've never seen such a thin shark. She was a female, so when we transported her back, we gave her a wash down. And we can see here, this is the actual top gum. Now, this never protrudes from the mouth. Usually you see just the teeth. As you can see on the bottom, see if we can find her. This is probably a better one. We can see here on the bottom jaw that there's no protruding gums. That's just a little bit of sand that's obviously in there. On the top jaw, all this gum is totally infected and swollen. So we can see the teeth, but the actual gum is protruding the mouth here. This is the wound that we think may be a stab wound. And of course, the dehydration of the animal. And of course, the fishing hook in the esophagus, which we can clearly see here, the fishing line coming out, that's going right down the throat there. This animal.
Can you run that back again?
Yeah. From?
From what, right down the throat.
Right, okay. So we can see this is the fishing line that was coming out of the mouth. It's going right down to the throat here. Yeah. And actually hooked in the esophagus. This is the better picture. Ulcers in the mouth here. We can see various ulcers around. Totally infected. In fact, you can even see not just the gums, but the actual teeth line here. As you know, sharks have got rows of teeth. They'll lose teeth. The actual line of the rotating teeth is very, very infected here as well. So this is a clear picture of it. You can see the lesion that this fishing hook has already caused. So the animal was in terrible condition, unfortunately.
Right. So, Deborah, just tell me what you think about the way the press, the popular press, deal with sharks. Do you think they're simply reinforcing the jaws myth? Will you tell us what you think the truth is?
Well, I think it's a shame, really, because I think that newspapers, journalism, actually spreading awareness is a very important message, a very important part of the work of rescuing animals and seeing the problems that especially the marine ecosystems are facing. So I think it's very important that the journalists and newspapers can actually spread awareness. But I definitely do not agree with the tabloid system, like, you know, front page of The Sun saying a man-eating shark was actually caused panic in on the beaches in Majorca. I think that hurts tourism. I think that's giving definitely the wrong impression. I would like for the press, all different media, press, television, radio, all different countries, to in some way, Richard, help conservation, because at the end of the day, we have to help this planet. We have many, many issues, probably future threatening issues, global warming, climate change, plastics, impacts on, as we've seen with the shark. So I think addressing these is very important, but I do think that people should give the truth, should actually relay what has happened. For example, this case with the shark, with the blue shark, it's very sad, Richard. It's very sad to see an animal impacted both indirectly and directly by humans when these animals are necessary and essential in our seas and oceans of the planets, because they keep a healthy balance in the seas. They are actually top predators on the superior part of the food chain. So we need these animals in the sea, and to impact on them and then to sort of like turn that story around saying it was the shark that was coming in to kill people, it's wrong. I think what we should do is relay the message of what's happened to this poor shark. The animal was in agony. We actually gave this animal a dignified death, and get the press and the media to help in conservationists to relay the truth and say, listen, we have to stop this impact in the seas, because if not, we won't have a future for the future generations. So that's what I think, that their little help, you know, when you say we've just got to put in just a little bit of help from each and every sector, each and every collective, each and every company, each and every particular organization, not just leave the big bulk to the experts, but also we should do that on a daily basis to get the consciousness out there on how we have to look after our planet.
Deborah refers to future generations. Well, here they are having fun. But how will they grow up with sharks in the oceans they inherit? Blue sharks eat fish and smallish prey, not little boys. Teeth, jaws, terror. A fatal combination endangering sharks all around the world. A blue shark can have a litter of up to 135 pups, but it will be the growing numbers of human babies that will make a difference as we put pressure on the oceans. The Daily Mail in June 2017 reported that a truckload of plastic enters the ocean every minute. At least this load won't. A manta ray and jellyfish. Or are they plastic bags? Here in England, dolphins are symbolic of the sea, home of sharks too, where the public can go looking or fishing. Lou is a famous centre for shark fishing, and that could be said to be controversial. Sharks are certainly a tourist attraction, bringing an income to Cornwall. However you look at it, glass-bottom boats are a possibility. Or you can get even closer, if you know the tricks of the shark fishing trade. The Shark Angling Club of Great Britain was founded in Lou, Cornwall over 60 years ago. It aims to promote the sport of shark fishing and to promote the conservation of sharks.
Yeah, it wasn't a bad day. We managed two blue sharks, about 40 and 50 pound. We expected more. We always expect or hope for more. But yeah, it was a good day, a few mackerel, a few whiting. But the sharks could have played a little bit better, but we managed to. So everybody was happy.
So tell me, what do you do? You're out there sort of trawling with a mackerel bait?
Yeah, we go out and we drift. We have rubby dubby, which attracts the sharks, which is chum in some languages. And yeah, the sharks smell the chum or the rubby dubby. They swim up the trail, take the bait, and we get them in. We get them aboard, take the hook out, and then we take a picture and pop them back in, and they're no worse for wear.
That's right.
Yeah, I mean, nowadays with the blue sharks, up until a few years ago, they were very heavily commercially fished. And now all the sports fishermen in Great Britain, at least, we all return the fish. So it's just catch and release. Whereas many years ago, they used to kill them, bring them in and weigh them. And now we just get them aboard, measure them, and pop them back in. So yeah, it's all catch and release now.
And here's a less stressful experience for the blue shark. Quite shy, really. But soon more arrive. And here's the deal. You can dive unprotected with them. Get great close-ups and vice versa. What's streamlining? It can make humans look clumsy. These trips are run by Charles Hood out of Penzance, off Land's End. This is called wrangling, and anyone can do it. Then it's all over. Blue sharks, away into the blue. And back to Spain. Being wide-ranging and highly migratory, they're vulnerable to high seas longline fisheries. EU landings from the Atlantic have tripled since 2002. An estimated 13 million blue sharks were landed by the EU fleet from the Atlantic and Mediterranean between 2000 and 2012. Some for food and some for fins. All around the world, sharks are under pressure, like here in Costa Rica, Central America. Local fishermen is one thing, but huge industrial fishing is something else. And all around the world too, it's Discovery Shark Week, somewhere. Shark-infested schedules. Saying what? To whom? Great gold versus great white. Famous Olympic swimmer races a great white shark. Allegedly a sham, a stunt in fact. And here's another way of saying something. A very short, very direct, award-winning film based on that famous sequence in Jaws, the movie, many years ago. The one that hurt sharks so much.
Thank you.
Yes, rethink the shark. Many more people are killed by defective toasters or even chairs. Those images are not unlike what happened, as seen on YouTube, just recently, in Majorca. We have invaded their world, usually aggressively and without thought. It's where they've thrived through the ages. In the tiny blip that is human time on the unique blue planet, we have polluted and trashed our only home, and theirs too, especially with plastic, drastically reducing their numbers by overfishing. We now behave more like the destructive, violent creatures that sharks are depicted to be. In fact, we are Jaws. That's the truth, whether it's on Majorca or almost anywhere else in the ocean. What happened in Majorca in June 2017 may affect how you see these creatures of the ocean.